Bid today isn't so much a project, it's more informational. I've had people ask me questions about brake lines, single and double flare, when you should and shouldn't use one. And so I want to make this video to kind of clear that up as to what you should be doing, when and why. So yeah, let's get started. So there's three basic types of flares I want to talk about. Two main ones, and then the third one I'll touch on, won't go into much detail on, because it's not really used on any of the vehicles I work on. It's mostly domestic, or I'm sorry, it's mostly foreign, not domestic vehicles. The three types of flares are a single flare, a double flare, also known as an inverted flare to some people, you might see it written that way, and a bubble flare. The difference is, and I drew these really chintzy sketches, so keep the laughter to a minimum. Single flare, effectively, this is your brake line. It flares out on the end one time. That's it. Done. It's the weakest of the connections you can have. It's made for low pressure situations like fuel, oil cooling, and transmission cooling. Not so much fuel as much anymore, but that's where you would have found it. The next one, which is the main reason we're here, the double flare. Basically the same as a single flare, except it swoops back in, which effectively makes it a lot stronger. Made for higher pressure situations like brake line. That's why you want to use that. The last one is a bubble flare. Bubble flare follows the same type pattern as the single and the double, except it goes out. And when it mates up with the incoming piece, it actually crimps down right in this area. It's a one-time use flare. Again, you'll find those in European cars, not so much domestic ones, because the standard for domestic cars is actually the double flare. As far as brake lines go. So you're fixing brake lines. Which one do you use, single or double? Well, like I said, the double is the standard, and it's actually the safest because it supports the most, it'll put up with the most pressure and abuse. Single flare, I'm not gonna lie, every vehicle I touched in high school had a single flare on it because I didn't know any better. And that's just the way it is. And I've seen it used today. Same thing with compression fittings. Yeah. I'll still use them, but it's a quick fix. If it's a daily driver, probably not gonna do that. Probably gonna replace the whole line, flare both ends, and you know, do it correctly, the way it should be, as it would have been from the manufacturer. Now, to do a single or a double flare, you're gonna need a flare kit. This one happens to be Aries lifetime warranty. Oh, nice. I got it off at Amazon. It's about 40 bucks. You can search around, I've seen it for 20, and there's different variations of them. But effectively, they all have the same basic stuff. They usually come with a little pipe cutter. They'll come with a little device to hold your line. They'll come with the actual flaring tool itself, which just cinches down and that goes inside your line. And then this one, since it's a double flaring kit, it comes with these little guys, which that is the double flare part, which I'll show you how to use in just a second. So, that being said, let's take a look at what it takes to make a single or a double flare. So with your single and double flare, basically you're going to have this no matter what. Now what this is it's a line holder. It's got ribs on the inside of these little chambers here, and it'll grip the line. And so what you want to do, you can do this in your hand, but a vise, I can get my hand out of the way, makes this a lot easier to do. Now this one, it's a single flare. The lines are printed, the size of the lines printed on this gauge, it's quarter inch lines, so we're gonna put it in the quarter inch one. We're gonna put it almost flush with the top of this gauge, pretty close. I mean, this is just for demonstration, it doesn't have to be perfect. We're gonna tighten this guy down, and then we're gonna take a flaring tool, and we're going to flare. Again, this is a single flare. You wouldn't typically do this on brake lines, at least you shouldn't. You can, I mean, I have, but you shouldn't. So that's about it. Well, that is essentially a single flare. Take a look at that. Fold it over just one time. All right, well, it's a double flare. Same thing. Gauges are printed on the sides, quarter inch line. We're going to put it in the quarter inch slot. Except this time, we're going to use our little quarter inch double flare buddy. It's got a quarter inch printed on it. Now what we do is set that down on top of the holder, and you want this lip to be about the same height as the top of that. So you'll kind of just twist her down until you get it pretty close. Get a little higher. Doesn't, again, this is just for demo, doesn't have to be perfect. You get that about the right height. Cinch that down. And then instead of just going straight to your flaring tool, you put this cap, which has got an inversion on here, in your pipe. Bring this guy across. We're going to crush him down. You go down until it's about flush down to the holder. Let's back it off. Now, if you see that, it's coned over. You can get right up on that and see how it's all bent over on the top. It's because we're halfway done. The rest of this involves, we go back to the flaring tool, put it in that hole. Just like we did the single flare. And you just cinch it down. Again, you don't have to destroy it, just get it down there. And what you have is now a double flare. So this one is twice as thick as the single flare we did on this side. And that is the difference between a single and a double flare. And that's how you do it. Well, that about does it for this video. Hopefully you learned the difference between a single and a double flare, and maybe why, and why you should not use them. The biggest thing with these is it's your brakes. You gotta stop somehow. Either this or drag your foot. I don't know. So anyway, appreciate you guys tuning in. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next project. Like and subscribe. See ya.